Good morning. It is 20th of July 2020, about 11 o'clock in the morning. Thought it's about time I spoke to you again. Hope everybody's okay. Everybody's safe and well in this bit of a funny time. Right, talk about today. Calling this hacks, proms, and other things. First thing is hack. I'm not talking about hacking as in the computer. What I'm talking about is DVDs. I wanted a TV series, and only problem is it's only being released in the USA. I live in UK, region 1, region 2. So how do I get it? Well, first off, let's talk about regions. As I understood, it originally had something to do with the TVs and the signals. Region 2 is PAL, P-A-L. Region 1 is N-T-S-C. And it's all the way that the old TVs, the cathode ray tubes, decrypted the signal. Now, modern TVs, flat screens, stuff like that, can cope with both PAL and NTSC signals. I'll show you in a bit. So I wanted this TV series, and it's an old series. It's come up on the 15th anniversary, and it's called The 10th Kingdom, a fantasy TV series. So they've remastered it and brought it out in widescreen. Only problem is, they've only released it in the USA, not in UK, not in region 2, region 3, region 4, or whatever. So I heard somebody say it's possible to hack your DVD player so it becomes a multi-regional DVD player. So I went online, lots of advice, but all of them said it all depends what DVD player you got. So I had to search out the information, what model it was. I know the manufacturer is Samsung, but what model it was. Eventually came to a hack. So now, if I turn this round, I've got, now I'm going to put this on play. Right, and I'll be putting a description in. This is a Region 1 DVD player. Playing in the UK. Probably getting into trouble off YouTube for this. Turn the TV off. So, or I always forget to wind out. Let me get the tripod set back up. So yeah, I've got it working. So I can watch The 10th Kingdom. Is that right? That's about right. Now, as I gather, this isn't illegal. You can quite well do it. It's not illegal. I've still paid for the DVD, even though it's classed as an import. But in today's world, is there any need to have discs in regions? Why not just do them all region free? Especially now, as you can see, the TV plays it perfectly. Obviously, if you've got an old TV, the old cathode ray tube, it won't play. I think it goes to black and white, somebody was saying, one thing was saying. So yes, I'm quite happy. Also, it means I could get some other TV series that have never been released in the UK. There's one which amazed me because it was in conjunction with a British TV company called Max Headroom, 20 minutes into the future. So I'll be able to get them. So I'm happy, and I'm amazed it's worked, because usually on these sort of things, with me, they don't work, but it works. So I can sit down and watch The Tenth Kingdom. The only problem is, they say, do not connect your DVD player up to the internet. Because now and again, it asks for updates of firmware, you know, the programs in it, and it could reset it back to region 2. You know, region 2 DVD player, which means you have to go through all the hassle again of resetting it to region 3. Because most DVDs players these days, you can watch YouTube, Netflix through them. Being able to hack the DVD, don't know of any way to hack the Blu-ray, but I'm happy. This is a 4.3 TV series that they've remastered into widescreen. Brilliant. Also part of this, you know, lockdown, not being able to go anywhere, I have actually been watching some stuff on YouTube. And there's been a couple of series, if you like, called Theatre at Home and The Show Must Go On. Shows, full theatre shows, being uploaded onto YouTube for people to watch. Watched a brilliant one yesterday. It was the Stratford Festival. When I heard Stratford, I thought Royal Shakespeare Company and stuff like this. No, it's Stratford. I think there's a Stratford-upon-Avon in Canada, and it was a Canadian company's production of Taming of the Shrew. Brilliant, fantastic, great. You know, I watched it, very good. So I might be watching a few more of them, but I have been watching quite a few of the Shakespeare plays. Right, Proms. Every year in the UK, we have this big classical festival, the Henry Wood Proemnade Concerts. Usually from the Albert Hall. It starts in July, usually second week in July to, I think it's the last week in September. Every day there's different concerts. Some could be European music, world music, classical music, more modern music. I mean, they've done stuff on Rodgers and Hammerstein, Bernstein. They did one on Hollywood theatre, Hollywood music and stuff like that. Unfortunately, this year, with it being the coronavirus, majority of it had to be cancelled. Now, this was a big blow. Until they've come up with a virtual Proemnade series. What they've done is gone through all the archives, chosen the best concerts they've done. I'm going to re-show them. Hopefully they said by the end of August they may be able to do some shows from the Albert Hall. Don't know what's going to happen with the last night of the Proms though. Last night of the Proms is, and go on YouTube, there's no doubt videos about it. This great big party night, lots of different music, pomp and circumstance, Rule Britannia, Elgar's sea shanties, and except brilliant. Don't know what they're going to do about that if it can't happen. So I'm happy. I've got my prom season. I can sit down and watch the proms. some proms. Some classical proms as well. From, when I say classical, I mean from past series of the proms. Another casualty of the COVID-19 for me is Christmas. People say to me, it's July. Why are you talking about Christmas? Right. Every year, I belong to a park Christmas saving club. I've got it loaded up on computer. I'll show you in a sec. What it is, it's something that you pay money into weekly and you can get some shopping through hampers. You can buy gifts and stuff like that. Due to the coronavirus, they said we're not delivering this year. Doesn't mean I'm going to lose my money. What they're doing is, what they're saying is, we're going to give you vouchers for online stores. If that makes sense. If that happens, I've got a contact, and when I finish paying it up, I've only got about a couple hundred, I'll check if they do from Morrison's, order online from Morrison's. The Christmas park campers, let me zoom in. I hope you can see that. My mouse is packed up for some reason, so I'm having to use an external mouse. Online catalogues, so you've got things like the gift cards and stuff like that. Christmas hampers, so you've got like the meat hampers. So, you know, you've got meat hampers. Then usually down at the bottom, they give you a description of what's in it. So there you go, beef joint, pork joint, gammon joint, chicken, half leg of lamb, shoulder of lamb, leg of pork, topside beef joint, turkey crap. So, basically that's it. But what I do is I order my booze. Those down at bottom are sort of gift vouchers, but I order the booze. So I've got the spirits. Those are like alcohol pops, you know, flavoured drinks, and my wine. So that's not going to happen. So what I'm going to have to do is go over to somewhere like Morrison's and order online. So, so if I click whiskies, you know, order whiskey, famous grouse, and also you do get offers. That was £17, it's now £14. That was Jameson's 30, it's now 25. And as you get nearer Christmas, you do find more offers. So that's what I'm going to have to do. Rums, dark rums, because I like Captain Morgan's or Lamb's. So that's what I'm going to have to do for Christmas. Again, I'm pulled out. As most of you know, I do Christmas shopping with my sister. We don't know what's going to happen with that. Oh, it's a bit crooked, never mind. Don't know what's going to happen with that. I haven't got a clue how we're going to sort that out and stuff like that. I can't see us going away to a big city or somewhere like that. It might be somewhere local, probably down Sheffield. The only problem is if this restrictions are still on, then you're having to queue up and wear face masks for every shop you go in. And yeah, I can understand the idea of wearing face masks. I've got no objections to it. In fact, I've just bought a new face mask with air venting. It's one of them that you put the filters in. So, we don't know what's going to happen there. I've already talked about getting presents over and presents back, and if she's coming over for New Year, she says she should still be coming over for New Year. But all depends. If we get a second spike, who knows? So that's been roughly it over the last couple of weeks. Playing about, seeing if I could hack it so I can get this TV series. So who knows, I might sit down and watch a couple of episodes of them this afternoon. Oh, I've got to nip down to shop. Need some bread. I'm doing some stew and dumplings. And yeah, bread and gravy afterwards. And oh, brilliant. Comfort food. It's what I call comfort food. It's that type of food that you eat and you go, oh. The only problem is, I think I've said this before, with stew, it's one of those meals I can go back and have a bit more. And then I think, oh, I'll just have a bit more. And then, until you're totally bloated. But I do a big pan, because then it lasts me 2 days. So it'll be my tea tomorrow. And when we're going back to work tomorrow night, it'll be my dinner in the afternoon. Some bread and gravy or whatever. But this afternoon, I might sit down and watch a couple of episodes of The Tenth Kingdom. Fantasy, not up to everybody's taste, but not a bad series. I wouldn't say it's children's fairy tale stuff. It's more the backstabbing and stuff like that. It's more adult. Teenager, late teenager, adult type stuff in it. So, yeah. Besides that, can't think of much else to say, except stay well, stay safe. Somebody asked if I was going on holiday, you know, even if a weekend away, and I would love to say yes, but do you particularly want to go away walking down a beach with a face mask on every time you want to go somewhere? And yeah, I know I'm safe. I wash my hands when I come in, I wash my hands, you know, regular, and I keep myself to myself. In some respects, it's not me, it's the other people out there you've got to be worried about. You know, are they taking the same sort of precautions? There's actually was a case a couple of weeks ago where somebody went on holiday and it was so saying, you know, it became badly there, got COVID. But when they were interviewing him, it turned out they'd had this fever before I went in and thought, oh, well, I'll just risk it in case it's a bit of cold or flu. No, I mean, those are the people idiots about you've got to be careful of. So besides that, nothing else to report, nothing else to say. No, nothing. It's being stuck in the house on my days off and... besides that, it's been going to work, coming home. Yes, this weekend we've got to wear masks in shops, so it's just one of them things. Stay safe, look after yourself, speak to you soon.